bit of distance, allows Hill to extend. He sticks the teep to the chin of Joey Contrada. 30 seconds remaining in this three-round, four-rules affair. Malcolm Hill.
Man, Malcolm would have stepped back there. He throws that 1-2, and he finishes the hook nicely. If he would have stepped back and made more room, he could have landed a couple more shots.
Despite Contrada appearing to put the weight on Hill, looks like Hill's the one better able to extend those knees in the clinch. Jamie Crowder will break him up once again. And the bell will sound. Three rounds in the books, Contrada and Hill. And it looks like we are actually going five here, so we will go into round four. Misspoke earlier. There's still plenty of time left for Contrada to pull it together and get himself back into this fight. With so far, I would have to say that Malcolm Hill's had the best of this exchange.
I think so. I mean, Joey's definitely coming on, I think, as the fight goes. Seems like he's got great conditioning. He's got a little bit of blood coming out of his mouth. That's never a good sign. It was coming from his lip or from his jaw.
Towards the end of round number three, Hill went right to the chin of Contrada with the teep, and that may have busted open Contrada's lip. Coming down his chin from the lower lip right now as we get ready to start round four. So here we go. Back to action we go. Contrada versus Hill.
Joey's definitely bringing it on.
And perhaps the taste of his own blood spurring him on a little bit as we begin this fourth round.
You know, it's nice to see a fighter who kind of had a kind of a rough go the first minute or so of the first round kind of come back like this.
Contrada has had flashes of brilliance in the ring before, and he's had a couple of fights in the past year canceled due to injuries to his opponents that were suffered in training, so he might be just dealing with a little bit of ring rust here. Not getting as much action as he would like. But now he's back in it, and he's in tough against Malcolm Hill. Contrada maybe having his best round of the fight so far. Two fighters exchanging knees in Contrada's corner, the blue corner.
See, Joey's definitely in great shape. Beautiful.
Punishing right hand thrown by Contrada as the blood comes out of his mouth. Big right hand from Malcolm Hill. And a leg kick from Hill as well.
I don't know if the blood's coming out of his lip or out of his mouth.
Malcolm Hill keeps working those leg kicks, those lower leg kicks.
Oh,
and a nasty left leg to the chin
push
again.
Push kick right to the jaw.
Malcolm Hill scoring some clean blows, although Contrada able to dump him onto the canvas there with the clock winding down in round four. A warning from Jamie Crowder, didn't like that push down by Contrada as the bell sounds and round number four is in the books. So Contrada came on strong there, had a good showing the first part of round number four, but then towards the end of that round, just a vicious left foot right to the mouth of Contrada. And that kind of put him back to square one, it seemed like.
Like I said, Joey's definitely coming on.
You're watching Friday Night Fights Muay Thai, brought to you by Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino, everybody. Glad you could be along with us for our season premiere, year number 20 on the Muay Thai circuit, the longest running Muay Thai series in North America.
Lip or jaw?
Ari Lagami with you alongside Jason Strout, the head coach of Church Street Boxing Gym. We are watching round five between Joey Contrada.
He had such success with that left leg, and then he went to his right. That left leg is so useful when the guy's walking in. Stops it dead in his tracks.
Contrada trying to force the action against Malcolm Hill. And despite being smothered, looked like Hill trying to, able to get off a couple of shots as he's being forced into the corner. Contrada tries the spinning back elbow, but a bit too slow. Hill tries to respond with one. And the blood you see on the head of Malcolm Hill is not his own.
Man, he keeps landing that push kick right to the jaw.
Usually you see the teeps land to the midsection, right, yeah. Jason? Not necessarily to the jaw.
Well, that's what I think
jaw.
That's what happens. You're not looking for it, and all of a sudden it sneaks up, catches you in the chin, and it kind of surprises you. Because, yeah, you normally do catch it to the chest, to the body. I've seen guys do it to the leg.
But Contrada, unfortunately, has been caught twice in the jaw.
Oh,
and Hill
beautiful.
With a nasty step and elbow, and then a kick combination. Leg kick from Hill, left hand from Hill, another
good combinations.
Body kick. Contrada reaching down, looking for that something extra as he tries to finish.
Putting together combinations is the key thing for these guys. You don't want to wind up with big shots. You want to go small, just busy.
Last 30 seconds of action here, round five, as Contrada and Hill suddenly in a wrestling match. Another left foot right to Contrada's jaw as the blood spurts out. Final 10 seconds here. Hill and Contrada locked up again. And the left elbow of Hill may have clipped Contrada on the way out. There's the bell. And what a competitor. Both of these men, of course, but Contrada, big smile on his face. He's bleeding, he's tired. The bell sounds, he's got a big smile on his face. You have to appreciate that. But a fun fight, Jason Stroud. That was,
sure
that
was.
Was a lot of action there. And Contrada, give him credit, looked like he was slowing down in the middle portion of the fight, but he came on towards the end, but Hill really never
looked
wavered.
It like, looked like Hill jumped on him early, and I thought it could have been a short night for him, but Joey definitely was brought it back to him. Dug deep, showed what kind of heart he has.
So we will go to the scorecards once again on Friday Night Fights.
Never count out them Boston fighters, right?
Absolutely. Joey Contrada, originally from Boston, Massachusetts, now calls Queens, New York his home. He trains out of King's Combat Fitness in Rego Park. Meanwhile, Malcolm Hill out of the Institute, his teammate Eric Jung, victorious earlier this evening. And Malcolm Hill trying to follow suit. Hill, 26 years of age. Contrada is 34. Both fighters having the gloves and pads removed now in the ring. We are awaiting the official decision. We're about to find out. Let's go to Connor Hall.
All right. Five rounds. Wow. Okay, we have our winner by unanimous decision. Representing Jersey, Malcolm the Lumberjack Hill.
As soon as the final bell sounded, Jason Stroud, Malcolm Hill raised his arms in victory. Hill appeared very confident that he was in fact the winner, and that's how the judges see it as well. Unanimous decision win for Malcolm Hill. What do you think?
I think it was a good decision.
Fought very well, landed some really impressive shots.
Did a lot of really good things in there.
Used that teep to perfection, even up near Contrada's face several times. Busted Contrada's lip or perhaps something inside of Contrada's mouth open. Contrada getting checked out by Dr. Rufus Sadler outside of the ring. Malcolm Hill is your victor on Friday Night Fights, brought to you by Mohegan Sun.